Well, good evening, YouTube. Had this show up in the UPS truck today. It's a CyberPower CP1000PFCLCD. Uninterruptible power supply, UPS. So I guess it's rated 1000 volt amps and 600 watts. And then it has the adaptive power feature. There's low line voltage, it can boost line voltage, raise it up, and then if it goes far enough out of tolerance, it switches over to battery backup. It's not a very large unit, but I got this mainly to hook up to my Synology Diskstation, especially now that I have the SSD cache. We've had two slight power glitches in the last month or so. In this last one, I think the power dropped to something around 50% for like six cycles, and my PC didn't do anything, but it was enough to shut off my disk station and cause it to reboot. And when that happens, the processor in the network attached storage box loses the memory that is storing the lookup tables for the SSD cache. And when that happens, that's just like erasing all the data in your SSD cache, and you have to start over from scratch. And that takes several weeks up to a month for the cache to rebuild itself to where it's reasonably effective. So I saw this was on Amazon. They had a one-day flash sale, $84, and I looked at that and decided that might be a handy thing to get, and it's on the list of supported UPSs for the Synology. When the UPS detects that the power's going out, it will send a signal to the NAS to power down, and then you can also configure the NAS to broadcast a power down signal to all the other devices connected to it. So if my PC is monitoring the NAS, it can also power down. So I'll probably actually put my PC on this as well. Let's take a look inside and see what it looks like. Okay, this is pretty much what comes in the box. This is the back side of the unit. So apparently you have five outlets on the left side that are battery backed up, and then the five outlets on the right side go through the surge suppressor side, and then it also has inputs for your incoming cable signal. And let's take a look at the front side here. Yeah, not much to it. It's a pretty small device. I guess this is your main power switch. So probably what I'll do is get it plugged in and get the battery charged up. Before I hook it up to the NAS, I might try actually doing a load test on this. Hook up a 100 watt light bulb and see how long it runs. That might be kind of interesting. Okay, YouTube, loaded up the Power Panel Personal Edition, PPPE.exe. This is the Cyber Power Monitoring Program. And there's your current status. Electrical power gives you the voltage. There's your battery capacity. Charging. I don't have anything plugged into the UPS right now. We've got outages, under, over, and boost. So I guess this is where it can boost the voltage if it drops too low. And so those are your two monitoring things. And then here's your configuration. So you can actually schedule. Oh, so you can have the UPS actually trigger on and off times. Notification. You can turn the beeper on and off, I guess. So that's your shut down the computer after the UPS runs for so a certain period of time, or you can shut down when the remaining time is a certain amount. Yeah, you could do 8 minutes remaining or shut off after five. So those are your two options. Probably have to play with those a little bit, see what works in practice. Then you have your voltage settings here. The UPS will intervene, AC falls below 88 or rises above 139. So you can change your transfer points there. So this is your kind of brownout and power surge settings. And then you also have sensitivity here. adjust sensitivity. So there's low, medium, and high. So I guess high sensitivity, it might switch over to battery more often. Medium is kind of in the middle, and low sensitivity if you're running off of a generator. So there's your configuration. So there's a few things you can adjust in there. And then there's a self-test. I haven't run that. It says it's never been run. Let's see what that says. Self-test in progress. It beeped there. It says it's working normally. And it passed the self-test. So I guess that's pretty much the contents of the program. I don't know if any of this will show up on my Synology NAS. So that's why I want to kind of take a look at this first. We'll plug it into the Synology and see if it has any configuration options. Yeah, so I checked the power quality notice that I got back about a month ago, and in that case the voltage was down about 80 volts for almost 2 seconds. So actually in that case the UPS would have intervened. It was below 88 volts. In that particular case, I didn't have any problems with the Synology NAS. It weathered that outage just fine. Actually, I think that's a pretty good setting, and I think I'll leave this on medium. It says leave medium sensitivity for utility power. I guess I can try that, and then if I notice any glitches, I can go from medium up to high. But I'll try medium, and I'll try the default setting here. I think that's okay, and we'll go from there. So anyway, I wanted to show you the software. This is running on my old Gateway laptop. So we'll see how this works. So if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below the video description. If you haven't already done so, you might consider subscribing to my channel, link in the lower right corner. And as always, thanks for watching.